Athens flying circus.
Lovely day, isn't it?
Tis that.
Are you here on holiday, or...?
No, I live here.
Oh, jolly good. I say, there's our sheep, aren't they? Yes, of course, I thought so. why are they up in the trees?
A fair question, and one that in recent weeks has been much on my mind. It's my considered opinion that they're nesting.
Nesting? Like birds?
Exactly. Birds is the key to the old problem. It's my belief that these sheep are labouring under the misapprehension that they're birds. Observe their behaviour. Take for a start the sheep's tendency to hop about the field on their back legs. Now witness their attempts to fly from tree to tree. Notice they do not so much fly as plummet. Observe, for example, that ewe in that oak tree. She is clearly trying to teach her lamb to fly. Talk about the blind leading the blind.
But why do they think they're birds?
Another fair question. One thing is for sure, a sheep is not a creature of the air. It has enormous difficulty in the comparatively simple act of perching. As you see. As for flight, its body is totally unadapted to the problems of aviation. Trouble is, sheep are very dim. And once they get an idea into their heads, there's no shifting it.
But where do they get the idea from?
From Harold. He's that sheep over there under the elm. He's that most dangerous of animals, a clever sheep. He's the ringleader. He's realised the sheep's life consists of standing around for a few months and then being eaten. And that's a depressing prospect for an ambitious sheep. He's patently hit on the idea of escape.
Why don't you just get rid of Harold?
Because of the enormous commercial possibilities should he succeed.
And what exactly are the commercial possibilities of avine aviation?
Bonsoir, ici nous avons les dirhams modernes du mouton anglo-français. Ce n'est pas le bon échappé, le pépé, le pompon, le échappé, le... Maintenant, quand le... comme ça, nous avons dans la tête le cabine.
Ah bon.
Ici, où se trouve le petit capitaine anglais, Monsieur Trumpshaw.
Vive Brian, whatever you are.
D'accord. Maintenant, je vous présente mon collègue, le pouf célèbre, Jean-Brian Jadabadi.
Et maintenant, j'ai le mouton, mais je voulais vous aller, j'ai le mouton, le landing, pendant les wheels, bon.
Bon, les wheels, ici.
C'est formidable, n'est-ce pas? Et bon, où? Ah, après, je suis allé, de l'imagine, de l'avion, de la... Derrière le mouton, bon. Tchouk, tchouk, tchouk.
Ah, merci beaucoup. Ah,
ben, suivez la piste, hein?
Ah, tais-toi, mais...
Ah, pardon.
Mais... Où sont les bagages? Ou le voyageur?
Le voyageur.
Casse pas.
Merci. Le voyageur. Les bagages. Ils sont ici.
Premier classe, second classe,
bagage.
Ah maintenant, quand la mais comme ça, mais comme ça. Démonstration fantastique. Sur toi. Un, deux, trois.
How do you get on with these French people?
Oh, very well.
So do I. Yes.
Me too.
Service, Mrs. A. Yes.
Oh, yes, I like them. I mean, they think well, don't they? I mean, be fair, Pascal.
Please, Pascal.
Jean-Paul Sartre. Yes, Voltaire.
Oh, René Descartes.
And now for something completely different. A man with three buttocks.
Good evening. I have with me Mr. Arthur Frampton, who has... Mr. Frampton, I understand you, as it were, have... well, let me put it another way. I believe, Mr. Frampton, that whereas most people have two, you...
I'm sorry?
Ah, yes, I see. Are you quite comfortable?
It's fine, thank you.
Mr. Frampton, vis-a-vis your rump.
I beg your pardon?
Your rump.
What?
Your posterior. Derriere. Sit upon.
What's that?
Buttocks.
How me bum!
Well, Mr. Frampton, I understand, Mr. Frampton, that you have a 50% bonus in the region of what you said.
I've got three cheeks.
Yes, splendid. Well, we were wondering, Mr. Frampton, if you could see your way clear.
Yeah, what's that camera doing?
Nothing at all, Mr. We were wondering if you could see your way clear to giving us a quick visual. Mr. Frampton, will you take your trousers down?
What? Get off! I'm not taking my trousers off on television. No, do you think I am?
Please take them down.
No.
Just a little bit.
No.
Now, look here, Mr. Frampton. It's perfectly easy for somebody just to come along here to the BBC, simply claiming that they have a bit to spare in the body department. The point is, Mr. Frampton, our viewers need proof.
I've been on Persian radio.
Get off!
Well, the figures know they've got three buttocks.
How?
We go cycling together.
Struth!
And now for something completely different. A man with three buttocks.
Good evening. I have with me Mr. Arthur Frampton, who... Mr. Frampton, I understand that you, as it were, have... let me put it another way. I believe, Mr. Frampton, that whereas most people... We do this just now.
Oh, yes.
Why didn't you say so?